Hey, this is James Han from University of Nebraska Lincoln, Agronomy and Horticulture Department. Today, I'm just gonna share with you guys our app called CornSoyWater. CornSoyWater is an irrigation app which helps farmers on irrigation decision making on his corn and soybean fields. That's the reason we call it CornSoyWater. Corn, soybean, and water. So it's developed for center pivot fields specifically. It's helped farmer to determine how much available water is in the soil in the fields he has in a real-time mode. And we give suggestion on whether he should or should not irrigate that field. In this video, I'm just gonna show you guys how to create a free account of CornSoyWater and how to add new fields in this account. So first, go to CornSoyWater homepage. CornSoyWater.unl.edu in your web browser, and then it will direct to you CornSoyWater homepage. For the first time user, you need to register an account. So click this sign up button. Now, fill out this registration form. So I get an email account called CornSoyWater@yahoo.com and a password for this CornSoyWater account you want to create it. Type on your name. Let's give a pseudo name, John Smith. Zip code and contact number. After you type all those information, click register button and you will see a pop-up window said activation email sent. Please check your email. Now, go to your Yahoo email, which you used to register this CornSoyWater account. Yahoo.com. Go to your mailbox. You will see this subject title, CornSoyWater activation link. Sometimes if you didn't receive this mail, check your junk box and probably it's end up over there. And in this email, you will see this activation account link. Click that, it will direct to you our CornSoyWater homepage. Now you can log in. Keep in mind, if you never activate your account, you will not be able to log in. So remember, activate your account first before you log in. Okay, after you log in, you see this first page of CornSoyWater. On the left side, we got a map of all fields, add a new field, delete fields, and show all fields. Today, we're going to focus on how to add a new field. Later on in the second video, we will explain the other functionality. So first, click add a new field. You will see select the crop and also this Google map. So first, you need to select a crop type. In this example, I will create a corn field. So I select corn. And then I need to find where my field is. So this is basically a Google map. And if you used Google map before, and you will know, like, in order to find a location, you need type of address. So I know my field is in Mead, Nebraska. I type Mead, N-E. And I will see this drop-down box. I search the first one and zoom out on the map and try to find my field. So my field is over here. Now I click the center of my field and you will notice that this red marker will be placed on the center. So one thing, notice that you need to actually put the marker in the center area of your field. Why? Because this marker serves two purposes. First is this marker will actually draw a 20 miles circle, and this circle will actually determine if you can create a field. So for example, like there's a lot of weather station near your field, and within these circles, it can actually retrieve the nearest weather station's data and send to the app. Why we need the weather station's data? Because you want to know what's the temperature, what's the humidity, and the most important, what's the precipitation near your region. See how it affects your soil water. So let's say we got a weather station data retrieved to your field. Luckily, you don't need to worry about the weather station. We will do that for you. You just need to place the marker in the center of the field. Okay, this is the first purpose. For the second purpose, surrounding this marker, it will actually generate 0.25 square miles box. You cannot see the box, but basically within this box, the app will determine the major soil texture of your field over here. So keep that in mind. You want to put the markers in the center region of your field. After you did that, click this proceed button at the bottom right side of the web page. Loading soil texture of your field. It may take 10 seconds. So what it do is the app actually retrieved the soil texture for you, so you don't need to worry about it over here. But later on, if you want to change that, we have that option. So in this input page, you need to do a couple of things. First is give a name of your field. Let's say I will name my field Meet Cool One, and then choose the planting dates of your field. So when you plant your field, and I remember it's April 27th. If you didn't remember that day, that's okay, because you can give an approximating day. But keep that in mind if this day is too much off from the actual planting days. So the simulation results will vary. Then choose a relative maturity days. Mine is 1/11. And you can find this information in the back of your seeds. And the plant population, what's the population you planned for your field? My is 34,000 per acre. After that, you want to fill out your soil property form. We have some default values set up for you. But if you know exactly what those values supposed to be in your field, you can always change those ones. For example, if you know your field is totally covered by last year's residue, it's 100% covered, you can choose 100%. And for the soil texture, we determine for you. But if you know exactly what the soil texture for your top food soil and the subsoil, you can always change that. For example, if you're pretty sure your soil is loamy soil at the top, you can change it to loam. After you fill out all those information, click the proceed button. Now, you will see the output page. This is basically what's the message we deliver to you, whether you should irrigate or not, and why. We get this notification message box, the result graph, and a summary table for you, and also irrigation events form. You can add irrigation events over here. If you want to know the detail how to interpret the result page, please see our video in part 2, Core Soil Water Demonstration. And if you have any question, email us at cornsoywater@gmail.com. Thanks for watching this video. Have a good weekend.